Hey, yo.
What?
Are you a Mirage?
Huh? What kind of question is that?
Well, I see you, but I know you're not really there. So, does that make you a Mirage?
No, dude, we've already gone over this. It's like movie magic. Right now, you're just talking to an empty couch, and I'm talking to an empty chair. The whole clone thing is done in post-production.
Oh, right, yeah. So, what is a Mirage?
This is horrible. I'm so thirsty.
Oh my God, Brian. Do you see what I see?
A Dr. Pepper machine.
Yes. Oh, I can taste it now.
Damn it. It was a mirage.
An RC cola machine.
So the reason that you can see anything at all is because when light is shined on an object, it bounces off that object, sort of, and then gets directed into your eyeball. And sometimes this is not a good thing. Once light is en route to your eye, one of three things is going to happen. It'll either make it to your eye unobstructed, it'll get refracted, which just means it gets bent in mid-flight, or it'll get absorbed by some other object and won't ever make it to your eye at all. Everybody knows about reflection because we've all seen a mirror. Well, not everyone. But in order to understand how a mirage is created, we need to understand why light refracts. Refraction, as described by Snell's law, is a phenomenon that occurs when a wave passes from one medium with a given refractive index to another, which results in the bending of the light as it crosses the barrier between the two mediums. And the go-to example is often a glass of water with a straw in it that appears bent, and that's usually where the explanation stops. But if we can understand why light bends as it passes through the water, then we can take that knowledge and apply it to a mirage, and suddenly everything makes sense. So let's just dive in. Light bends, or refracts, when it changes speed. That's the core of the whole thing. So the water in the glass causes the light to slow down as it passes through, which is why the light bends. Now this may sound strange to you because you've always heard that the speed of light is one of nature's constants and moves along at a steady clip of 186,000 miles per second. And that's true in a vacuum like outer space. But as soon as the light crosses the barrier between two areas of differing densities, it bends. And the amount that it bends depends on its wavelength as well as the refractive index of the medium that it's passing through. Now, I'm gonna skip over the whole wavelength part because that's a discussion about quantum electrodynamics and is beyond the scope of this video. Now back to the good part. The next thing we need to understand is that obviously the Earth's atmosphere is more dense than the vacuum of space. So by the time the light from the sun has reached the surface, it's already been slowed down by a small amount. And another thing to note is that the energy from the sun doesn't heat up the air in the atmosphere directly, but rather it heats up the surface, which absorbs that energy and then re-emits it as infrared radiation, which is what actually heats up the air. So let's change gears for just a second and talk about air temperature and how it relates to air density. Temperature is just a measure of the average amount of energy that molecules have in a given area. And the more energy they have, the more they jostle around and the harder they bump into one another. And the harder they bump into each other, the higher the air pressure is in that area. So to summarize, the higher the air temperature, the lower the air density. And remember that density, or more accurately, the refractive index, is what affects the speed of the light, which is what causes it to bend. So let's imagine that it's a hot day, you're driving down the road, and the sun is beating down on the asphalt. And if you live in Texas like me, then you know that it can get so hot sometimes that farmers literally feed their chickens crushed ice to keep them from laying hard-boiled eggs. Aw, come on, that was a good one. All right, back to the thing. The energy from the sun gets absorbed by the road, which then heats up the air just above ground level. And this causes a difference in density between the hot air just above ground level and the cooler surrounding air. So now picture a car a little ways down the road out in front of you, along with a mirage that looks like the back of that car reflected in a puddle of water. But, as I mentioned earlier, a mirage is the result of light being refracted, not being reflected off of a puddle of anything. Normally, on a day when the temperature isn't especially hot, some light from the sun will hit the back of that car and then get reflected downward onto the road. But on a hot day, after the light gets reflected downward, it encounters that layer of warmer... But on a hot day, after the light gets reflected downward, it encounters that layer of warmer, less dense air just above the asphalt, causing it to change speed, which results in the light bending upward and into your eye. Let's go ahead and take a look at an animation so that we can put all the pieces together and hopefully make sense of all this. Here's a scenario. You and your friend are driving down the road in separate vehicles a few hundred feet apart. Your friend is in the front, and you're in the back.
Phrasing, boom! Inappropriate.
On a cool, sunny day, light from the sun will get scattered off the back of your friend's truck in all different directions. Some will get reflected up into the sky, some will get reflected back towards you, which is what you see when you look at the truck, and some will get reflected downward toward the road. The difference comes when we're dealing with the same situation, but on a very hot day. The light still scatters off the back of the truck, just like on the cool day, but this time, the light that would normally get reflected down onto the road encounters a layer of warmer, less dense air. This changes the speed of the light, which causes it to bend and get redirected towards your eye. This, of course, creates an image of the back of the truck on the road out in front of you because that's where the light came from. And this image is what we call a mirage. A very common mirage that people see is one that looks like a puddle of water. And in this case, the exact same thing is happening except without the back of the truck. And the image looks like water because they're seeing the blue light from the sky. All right, that's it. I'm calling this one done. Besides, I think someone's trying to steal my car. Probably should have parked it in the mirage. That didn't even make sense. A man walks into a bar with a slab of asphalt under his arm and says, "I'll have a beer and one for the road." Okay, I'm done.
So we've
Dude.